those who have been chosen for this new world that's coming in, this new community of people with a new life and new light for Islam. Those of you who are chosen, you cannot change your direction. I don't care how uncomfortable you are with me, you can't go anywhere else. You have been chosen. You can't go anywhere else. So forget about it. You're not going anywhere else. You're going to have your differences as to how to read scripture. You're going to have your differences as to how to read Professor Farrar's esoteric language. But you ain't going nowhere. No, you're going to stay with Imam Nebula Deen Mohammed because you have been chosen by a power bigger than you. You're going all the way home.
I seek refuge with God, the Most High, the Creator of all systems and knowledge. I seek refuge with Him from the Shaitan and the devil. I'm going to just read this brief statement, and then we can, if you have a few questions, then I can try and answer them. In 1975, when the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the leader of the Nation of Islam, passed, his son was unanimously voted in as the leader of the Nation of Islam. Upon his immediate leadership, he immediately freed us as individuals. He gave us the Quran, and he showed us through his life that the best example of life and goodness is the life of the Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah, prayers and peace be upon him. And then he freed us as a community by making all masjids, Islamic centers, autonomous. And then he gave that freedom that he gave to us, gave us the sensibility to be free to choose unity. He spoke very animately about unity this last Labor Day weekend at the Juma. He told us that every Muslim, every man, every woman, and every child of puberty age and above, that we are to be leaders, that we know how to do janazahs, that we know how to lead the Juma, that we know how to do all of the traditional and all of the spiritual and religious things that our holy book prescribes and that the life of Prophet Muhammad, prayers and peace be upon him, has shown us. So I ask that we all have God's mercy, because my father was not just our father, but he was our leader. And he was not just your leader, he was your friend. He was many of you all's father. And I know that we are all grieving together. And I just ask that we pray for not only his soul, because this is Ramadan, the most merciful holy month. And we believe and we know that when a Muslim passes in the month of Ramadan, they go straight to the Jannah. God willing, our leader, my father, our father, is in the paradise. So I ask that, of course, we will pray for Imam Muhammad's soul, but I ask that we pray for each other and that we stand firm with not only the African-American Muslims, but with all Muslims, and not only with Muslims, but with faith communities. The Muslims, the Christians, the Jews, this is Imam Muhammad's work. He is a man that led humanity. and a man that believes in God, and we should remember his leadership. And there is no successor. He has given us what we need to be leaders and to be followers. And I think that he did a wonderful job. And I thank Allah for my father. And I thank Allah for my leader. As-salamu alaykum.
The family will entertain some questions directed towards Layla at this time. A few questions. Many in this room are students of Imam W.D. Muhammad. And all of it, everyone that you would talk to in this room will give you a different reason, perhaps, why they came to the religion of Islam through the leadership of Imam W.D. Muhammad and what that leadership has done for them. But all of us will agree on one thing, that his leadership reinforced in us, and he insisted upon us, that we can be Muslim and American. Long before there was a 9/11, he put the flag of the United States on the masthead of this newspaper. We didn't just do it on September 12th, 2001. It was there at least 10 years earlier. When he came and led his father's community, which was coined a black separatist movement, on the stage before all of his father's followers, he said, if you will not pick up this American flag, then I will have to pick it up for you. And what he was telling us was that our ancestors, and before the Janazah, we have on this wall a picture of Frederick Douglass and his newspaper that he started, the North Star, and what that means for us as African Americans, and that we were born as slaves, and that we are the descendants of slaves, but yet and still we have to make a full adjustment and move forward and accept that we are American citizens. And whatever grievances we have with America, we'll take it up with our own government. You will not find within these walls or within these individuals or Muslims, there are no terrorists here. But we will take our government to task for when we think it is wrong and when we think it is not behaving up to its own constitution, the constitution which we've lived in our lifetime to see America own up to, because when it was written, they were lofty ideas, and no, they are more than just words, but they were words that had to be lived up to. Because after all, Dr. King, it was in the 1960s when Dr. King had to have the Voters' Rights Act passed. And he was sitting in the Birmingham jail. And he was sitting in the Birmingham jail before the government acted. He was already in jail. It was after the people rose up and after interreligious groups rose up. And we had the Freedom Riders who came south. And there were Caucasians, Jews, and African Americans among those Freedom Riders. And we remember their deaths in Philadelphia, Mississippi. We remember Emmett Till, but at the same time, we remember that we are American citizens, we are Muslims, and we insist that our country hold up to its lofty ideas that are presented to us within the Constitution. Sister Layla, are you ready?
Yeah. I would like to just say one more thing. I meant to say this because it's very important that we don't let negative forces divide us. So I wanted to ask if the imams here, we have imams from all different communities here, and they all love Imam Muhammad. And Imam Muhammad, though some people may not have very visually been under his leadership, but I